everybody, I hope we're all doing well today. So today we are going to listen to the song Shattered Image by Dolly Parton. We are going to listen to the song and then we're going to do a little bit of talking about it. So I know you have it pulled up, which wouldn't happen in the natural session, but that's okay. So go ahead and play our song for us. Attention to the lyrics, what she is saying, what you think of her tone of voice, what you think that means for her. So keep that in mind when we listen to it again. Go ahead and restart it. Gather your thoughts, and we can have you go first, and I want you to kind of tell me what you think, what you heard. Did it sound the same both times through? Did it sound the same the first time versus the second time when you were really paying attention to the lyrics and the artist's tone of voice? What kind of instruments did you hear? That kind of thing.
Well, it's definitely a stringed instrument, and I am no expert, so I don't know. It sounded like a banjo, maybe, but I noticed it was very upbeat, but yet the lyrics, the second time I listened really closely to the lyrics, and I felt like the lyrics were really deep. Does that kind of answer your question?
Yeah, good. What about you?
Well, I heard a fiddle, not a banjo.
Hey, what can I say, you know?
I like the lyrics. You know, she's talking about people being mean and cold and shattering her image, and I like that.
What about you?
I was going to say banjo.
See?
But I don't know. I was listening to the way that she said, I shattered my image, that she was her own worst critic.
Yeah, that's very true these days. You look in the mirror, what do you see? All of your worst things about yourself, the things that you feel like everybody else sees, but maybe they don't. Maybe they see the good parts in you. So what do you think that means for the artist? What do you think she was feeling when she was going through the song? Who wants to start?
I'll start. I was gonna say, I noticed when I listened to it in the beginning, she kept saying, like she said, she was on the dock and she was looking at the water and she shattered her image. But then later on in the chorus, she said she was talking about people in the world and the world is cold and they shattered, I don't know if she said you or they shattered your image. And I almost had this impression like, you know, when you're growing up, you're so worried about your image. So you're focusing on it and you critique yourself and you're your worst critic, kind of like you said. But then as you advance and you grow older, you become more wise and you have this image of yourself that you try to live up to, and people around you in some ways try to bring you down and shatter your image.
Yeah, that was really good.
Deep.
I said deep. That's
deep is deep. I feel like she's trying to tell people something she went through to help them not go through it the same way.
Yeah, I agree. Last one. What do you think?
I think she's just pointing out a truth found in the world. I don't know.
Yeah, that's good.
Everyone's a meanie, but...
Everyone's a meanie?
Mm-hmm. Meanie butt.
Oh, a meanie butt. Gotcha.
So now how do you think you can take this into your life? What do you think this song might do for you in your life? How do you think it would apply to you personally?
Go ahead, go first.
Go for it.
I was thinking, like, it takes, like, a deep thought, like what I just explained and what they just added to as well, but almost makes it, like, the song, the feeling of the song is not, like, sullen and depressed. It's upbeat. Like, the music is upbeat, and it's kind of like, this is a story I'm telling, but now I'm rising above it with the music, and the music is happy and bubbly and...
Yeah, that's good. Next.
I feel like if you've gone through something hard, you can tell other people about it and kind of use that to encourage them. And that's what she's doing. She's encouraging people, something she went through that was hard.
Yeah.
That's good. Deep.
I guess I take it as other people have been through things that I go through every day. And so there's always someone to talk to.
Yeah. All right. Last question. How do you think you can take these insights that you just told me about her telling these stories to other people and trying to help them through it? How do you think you could take that into your own life?
I mean, I think you can be, first of all, to be sensitive to other people's feelings and what their image of themselves might be. And having gone through that yourself, as Laurel explained, like using your own experience as like sharing of wisdom. At the same time, with that upbeat sound of the song is like, I don't know, it's just energy provoking for you to like to rise up above your issues. You know, you're not defined by your issues, I guess.
That was a wonderful answer.
Because it covered everything.
Yeah, I know. It's hard when we're in a group, huh?
I'm just deep.
I think it's a good reminder that just because bad things happen doesn't mean that it's true. Just because somebody says it doesn't mean that it's true about you. And just because it's hard doesn't mean you have to be sad and grumpy about it.
Yeah, I like that. What about you?
That's pretty much the same path that they did. I don't know.
No, that's okay. When you're in a group, you tend to have some of the same answers.
But Kylie, it's something I just had a thought based on what you said. Notice the song talks about image. So going even deeper, like we are not our image. We are authentic. There is an image, but we are authentic.
Very deep here today. Lots of layers.
Insightful. I was going to say insightful.
Well, you see the reflection on the water, but that's not really what's below the surface.
Okay, so now we're going to do a little activity so everybody can take paper and a paper holder and a pen.
Thank you.
So a lot of the times these days, I know we all tend to have trouble seeing ourselves without our worst qualities. And we say to ourselves, we are not good enough because we don't have things that other people do. We just see the bad things. So I want everyone to take a minute and think about some things that you really like about yourself, your self-image, how you might appear to other people. And I want you to write down one or two things that you like about yourself, that you think are really good qualities about yourself and your image personally.
So we're writing two things about ourselves right now.
Yep.
Okay.
and take your papers. Thank you.
Okay.
There you go, ma'am. Miss West.
Okay, so now without you lovely people knowing whose papers these are, I'm going to read some of our really great qualities that are a part of our group for all of you guys here today. So we have qualities like we are passionate about things, we are patient and kind, we have good people skills, and we are very thoughtful. And we are pretty happy and bubbly, easygoing. So these are some of our good qualities about ourselves. So when you have one of those bad days and you feel like you're just shattering your image over and over, you're throwing the stone into your reflection in the water, you need to think about these things that you wrote down about yourself and say, I am these things. I am pretty darn cool. So with that in mind, I'm going to hand you another piece of paper. And I want you all to write down two things that you like about each other, that you think are really great about each other. And because of time purposes, you're gonna write two things down about one person. So you are gonna do you, you're gonna do him, you're gonna do her.
Oh, okay. So I'm writing two positive things about her.
Yep.
Choose wisely.
A list of mile of 2, 3, 4, 5 miles long. It's hard to narrow it to two things.
When you guys are done, I can take your papers.
Donovan seems to be struggling.
Who's he writing about me? Oh boy.
Alright, so
it was hard to pick two things.
Uh-huh.
So some things about Donovan is he has a great sense of humor and he is very smart.
Breach.
And some things that Donovan said about you that are really great is your drive and your bubbly personality.
Aw, thank you.
And then he said about you that you are full of wisdom and you are compassionate. So you see how these things that were on your guys' list that you like about each other weren't necessarily on your own list? So sometimes you see the qualities in other people that you don't see in yourself. So you kind of got to think about that sometimes. So with that in mind, we're going to wrap things up today, but thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss West.